Hello everyone, welcome to our craft video this week. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to talk about four different types of braids. I'm going to teach you how to do regular braids, I'm going to teach you how to do French braids, and then we're also going to cover Dutch braids, and then at the end I'm going to show you how you make Kirsten's hair, so how she has those braids tied up on the ends like that. Or for this craft project today, you're going to need a doll with some type of hair that is easy to braid. You are going to need hair ties. I like to use little rubber bands for them. I find them easier to put into the doll's hair. But if you don't have little rubber bands, hair ties work perfectly fine. At the end, when we go to do Kirsten's braids, we're going to need bobby pins. And then if you want ribbons or anything like that to put into your doll's hair, you can of course use those too. Okay? So we are going to cover regular braids first. I'm going to move you guys down just so you can see Josephina's hair now. It's all nice and long. I brushed it so that it is nice and untangled. So when you regular braid, you're going to take the hair, you're going to split it into three different parts. Now try to get all the hair to kind of lay together nicely. There we go. Okay. So when you regular braid, what you do is you start on either side, does not matter which side you start on. You take the outside one, you go over the middle, see it going over the middle, and then the middle comes out and becomes the side piece. There we go. And then whatever is the other side, you're gonna take that, is going to go over the top, the middle is going to come out on the other side, and then you have a new middle piece, and you should start to look like that. So again, you're just going to switch to the other side. You're just alternating sides for this. Cross it over the middle. Bring the middle underneath. Pull it a little bit tight. And then this side, over the middle. Middle comes underneath. There you go. Other side, over. Middle comes under. This side, over. Middle comes under. There we go. And you just keep switching them until you get to the bottom of the braid. And you can do the bottom of the braid wherever you want to. You don't have to braid all the way down. I've seen people tie them up here. So it kind of is like a half braid, half ponytail. You can do it however you want to, but then you just braid down, keep switching them. Once you get to the point where you can't really do it anymore is when you stop. You take your hair tie and then you just put it around the bottom of her braid and then you have a braid. So that's one that if you haven't really braided before and you want to practice, that is always obviously the best one to start with. But you can see her nice braid there. All you did was take the three pieces and alternate switching them over. And you got a nice braid in her hair. And then look how nice she looks in the front. And this one's nice because her hair always gets stuck around her earring, but you can just pull it out. You can pull out the front up here a little bit so it matches on both sides. And there you go. Look how good she looks. If you're really good at regular braids and you would like, you can also do French braids. French braids is the next step up. So for French braids, you're going to start right at the top of the head. You're just going to grab a little bit of the hair. You're not going to grab all of it this time, just a little bit of the hair. And what you're going to do is you're going to now split this into our three pieces. Okay. So we have our three pieces. One, two, three. See them all there. So what you do for a French braid is you're still going to be going over the bottom one, but when you go over, what you're going to do is you go and you grab a little bit of hair and you put it in before you cut it over. So now I have a really big piece here. It's going to go over. Middle is going to come under. Normally, we're not adding anything to that. Now when this side decides to come in, we're again going to grab some hair, pull it over, and then go over. Middle stays the way it is. We don't add anything to that. Pull it over. Now this side, we're back to this side. Again, you're going to grab a little bit of hair. You don't want to grab too much at a time or else you're going to run out before you get to the bottom of your braid. But you add it. So see, I took it. I added it to the piece we already had. And then you go over. So each time you go to a different side, you just grab a little bit of the hair that's still hanging there. You put it with the piece that's going to go over the middle piece. And then your middle piece comes out. On that side, this side, grab the hair, you're going to go over, middle stays the same and gets pulled out on the side. This side, grab your hair, there we go, pull over, middle comes under, there we go. This side, grab some hair, pull over the middle, middle comes out normal. And this side, this is going to grab the last of the hair, go over the middle, middle comes out under, and then you just braid it back down like we just did a regular braid. So now you're not adding any more hair, but you're just taking the sides and alternating, going over the middle, middle comes under, and then you braid it on down to where you want it. I'm going to stop halfway down because I like that look on her sometimes too, since she kind of has a ponytail also. And then you just tie it off. I like to start mine usually more up on top of her head if you're going to do a whole French braid down. But you can see this one. So what it is you can see how each time we added hair, we'll see on this side, and then it's a nice French braid. I'm sorry her hair is kind of hard to see with the dark color. But you can see her French braid and how nice it looks. Okay, we have one more braid I was going to teach you today. It is called a Dutch braid. Sometimes they're called inside out French braids. Let me get all of her hair done. I'm gonna brush through it super quick just to get all these hair nice and smooth again. There we go. So you're going to go to the middle again, grab your small chunk just like you did for the French braid. Get your small chunk, get all the under little hairs from sticking on it. Excellent. So you're gonna start with your hair. You're going to do your three pieces again. One, two, three. Three pieces of hair. It might be weird the first few times you do it, but I definitely say keep trying, try it on your doll, because if you get good enough, these are kind of braids that you can do on your friends and your siblings and even on yourself. Like, I'm able to do these braids on myself now because I was able to practice on my doll. So I definitely say to try this. So right now you have your right side, your middle, your left side. So in this one, instead of taking the hair with the piece that's going to go over, you're going to be adding to the middle piece. So if your right side is going over, your middle is going to grab hair from your left side. You're going to put it in with the middle, but your middle gets it, and then your right piece goes over, or middle comes under, and then you have a new middle piece. Now your middle piece is going to grab from the side that you just brought this on. So we just brought it on this side. Now we're going to grab hair, add it to our middle piece, and then our middle is still going to go under. This piece is not getting any new hair. It's going over, but it becomes the middle piece. And now it gets hair from the side it just came from. So we're going to grab, so the middle, we're going to grab a little bit of hair from that side, put it into the middle. It goes under this piece. So you can see your middle piece is here. You have this piece is staying here. And then your new pieces of hair are going under this piece, getting added to the middle piece, and then it's going under your right side piece. Again, we just added to this side, so we're going to now take hair from this side, go under our piece we just braided over, add it to the middle, and now the middle is going to go under your left side. There we go. Again, we just braided this side, so now we need to take hair from this side, add it to the middle, and then braid under the other side. The side you just went on, we're going to take a little bit of hair. We're going to add it to the middle, and then it's going to go under the other side. Take from this side, add to the middle. There we go. And then under this side. There we go. Take from this side. There we go. Add to the middle, under the other side. There we go. Take from this side, add to the middle. There we go. Go under the other side. And then that middle piece is going to grab the final chunk right there. There we go. And then it is going to go under that one. And then you just regular braid it out. So it's like the French braid, instead you're just adding it to the middle piece. So it's hard to kind of get your fingers going at first to remember that the piece that you're adding goes under the piece that's hanging here. So the braid sticks out. It's all cute. It's a nice Dutch braid. It looks really cute when you start it up top and go because it can get kind of big. And then these ones, once you tie them, let me get my hair tie. You can tie these braids. There we go. And then you can take your fingers and just gently pull the braid, and it makes it nice and big for where you made it. So it makes it look like a big old braid on her head. There we go. I'm going to tilt the camera up a little bit more so you can kind of see it, see how it's sticking out. And then I told you we would do Kirsten's braids really quick. So this is just a simple one. So even if you're not ready to French braid or Dutch braid, you can do Kirsten. So again, I'm going to take Josefina's braids out. I'm going to take her brush and just brush her hair really quick. 1, 2, 3. There we go. Look how nice she looks. Okay, so we're actually going to take her hair, split it right down the middle. We're going to get ones on either side. So we're going to kind of give her pigtails. I like to tie one off to the side while I braid the other one, just so that the hair doesn't get in the way and I don't accidentally grab too much hair on one side and then the other side is too small. So what you're going to do is you're going to take your side of hair right here. See, no hair there. Side of hair. You are going to do your regular braid. Again, we're going to get three pieces. 1, 2, 3. There we go. And then we are going to just simple braid. So side comes over, middle comes out underneath, side goes over, middle comes out underneath, over, under, over, under, all the way down her side of her head. There we go. Oops, there we go. And we're just going to keep braiding. There we go. Excellent. This will give her little pigtails too. So then little braids are nice because like you can do things where you can just braid a tiny piece up here to like put back and like hold her hair back while the rest of her hair is down. You can do braids like this. You can do big braids. Simple braids are really, really nice because it's the foundation of all the other braids. So it's a nice one to know. And it's one that you can just do simple, quick hair looks with. So now we're going to braid the other side. We're going to get our three pieces again. 1, 2, 3. And then we're just going to simple braid. So one side over the middle, middle comes out underneath. Side goes over, middle comes under. Side over, middle under, side over, middle under. And then you just keep going down until you get to the bottom of her braid. Braids like this are super nice because they're the foundation of the other braids. So once you get this, you can figure out how to French braid, because then you're just adding the hair to it when you go over. And then the Dutch braid, because then you're just adding hair underneath instead of over. Okay, so what you're going to do after you do the braids is you take it, you're going to loop it up towards the front, because then these little brush hairs that look like a little paintbrush will end up towards the back of your head. You do it like that, and then you take your bobby pins, and you put your bobby pins in to hold it. I sometimes like to go around the rubber band, put it in through there, and then usually one through the back to kind of hold those back, all these little hairs back here from the end of the braid. You put a bobby pin in right there. And be careful because you don't want to get them too hard into their hair because obviously it's not real hair. It's a nice little wig. So you don't want to be too rough with the bobby pins. But then it loops around like that. I already did our other side. And there she is. She has hair like Kirsten in our books. So you learned how to do regular braids, French braids, Dutch braids, and then Kirsten braids. Once you learn how to do a regular braid or even a French braid or a Dutch braid, you can do so many different hairstyles on your doll. I hope you had a lot of fun. I hope you try these out. Once you get the hang of them, I would love to see pictures of the braids that you're able to do. Or bring your doll in once the library is open again and show me them. I'd love to see them, okay? We'll see you soon.